अच्छे तुम रहा।
यस सर।
ओके लेट्स स्टार्ट। सो टुडे विल स्टार्ट राइटिंग प्रोग्राम। ओके फॉर अ टाइमर। नाउ दीज आर द स्टेप्स। फर्स्ट वी विल चूज अ टाइमर। नॉर्मली वी चूज इन आवर केस द 16 बिट टाइमर, दैट इज टाइमर 1, 3, 4 and 5, एनी वन। And we choose the value of the P scalar also because we want to slow down. Otherwise, the timer will increment its count value very fast. That high speed counting may not be required in most of the cases. Okay. So we will choose a P scalar to step down the system clock or oscillator clock. So our timer clock will be the reduced version of reduced frequency compared to the oscillator clock or system clock. Then in the step 2, we will choose the timer mode, a normal mode, CTC mode or any other mode. In our case, only 2 modes, CTC mode and normal mode. But presently, we are interested in normal mode only. So accordingly, we have to store the required content of bit in the TCCR A and TCCR B control registers. Then we will find out that to attain a particular timer value, to attain a particular time, what should be the required count value or the initial count that we need to store in TCNT register, that is TCNTH and TCNTL, total 16 bit registers. So that initial count must be stored in the TCNT. From TCNT, it will count up and it will go to the maximum count. And it will, and there will be the overflow and the timer will be stopped by us once the overflow is reached. So that time required to attain the overflow will be our required time delay. Okay. So that's how our initial count of the timer must be calculated first. And after calculation, that will be stored in TCNT register. Then step 4. In step 4, once that we'll wait for the timer to attain overflow. Once it attains the overflow, the TOB flag of the timer will be 1. The TOB flag we know is stored in the TIFR register. So we'll check the status of TOB flag. If it is equal to 1, it means the counting is complete. The timer has attained overflow. Then we want to clear the overflow flag. Then what we'll do? Okay, we will reset. Okay. Then what we'll do? First, we'll stop the timer. Okay. We will just stop the timer by resetting the CS bits. Okay, of the timer control register. Then we will clear in the step 5, we will clear the TOB flag by writing a 1 to its position. So that is the method. Now let's see how we can do it. One problem for us. Now, so let the onboard oscillator of an 8MHz 2560 based board is 16 MHz. That is not the theoretical value. Practically, our oscillator frequency is 16 megahertz. 16 megahertz. Clear? Then we will design a timer. Then we will design a timer to generate a time delay of 1 second. Okay. So, our first thing is we will choose a timer. Okay. Any timer we can choose. So, first we choose a timer 3. We choose timer 3. You can choose any other timer 4, 5, 1, anything. Okay. Now, what is our required time delay? That will be generated by the timer. As per the problem, it is 1 second. Our oscillator frequency or system frequency is 16 megahertz. Now, you will select a prescalar value, S. Okay. Prescalar value, some S. Okay. So that system frequency, F oscillator, will be divided by S. Divided by S. Then what we will do? Once it is divided by S, so first we will choose what the value of S. Okay, so we are choosing a timer and the value of the piece killer. How do you choose the value of the piece killer? The select a particular CS bit. So this is the bit description CS0, CS30, 31, and 32 for the TCCR3B control register. For the TCCR3B control register. Now we assume that we want to choose a piece killer of 1024. Just 1024. So our S equal to, just our S equal to 1024. Okay, so S equal to 1024. Now how to get S equal to 1024, the piece killer value? These CS bits will take 101. So these are the CS bits, it will be just 1, 0, and 1. These values. Clear? So it is set, but the mode of the timer is not yet set, that are WGM bits, WGM32 and WGM33. Okay, so how to set it? See, TCCR3, so we select the timer mode using WGM bits. So we have to set WGM30 and WGM31 in TCCR3A and TCCR3B in 3B, then it will be WGM32 and WGM33. So there are 4 bits. WGM 0, 1, 2, and 3. 4 bits are there in 2 control registers. So what we do? We just select a normal mode. A normal mode means all the 4 bits are 0, 0, 0, 0. All the 4 bits are 0, 0, 0, 0. 0, 0, 0, 0. Right? 0, 0, 0, 0. Therefore, now we are writing it as 0000, 4 number of zeros here. Then what we'll do? So this, once we place these 2 number of zeros and that zeros, our TCCR3A and TCCR3B, they are already attaining the proper bit pattern. So what will be the bit pattern? TCCR3A equal to 00 hex and TCCR3B equal to 05 hex. This 05 hex. So that is the required control resistance, the required value of control resistance. So once we decide the control register, then we will find the value of TCNT, that is the initial count. To attain a 1 second delay, we have to find out the value of initial count. How we can do it? We know our timer clock frequency is 16 megahertz. It will be divided. So our timer clock is what? System clock by S, prescalar value. So it will be 16 megahertz by 1024. So result is 15,625 hertz or 15.625 kilohertz. That is the timer clock frequency. Now what is the timer clock period? Capital T, it is 1 by F. So 1 by that second. So to attain a time delay of 1 second, what should be the required count? Now, one count requires a time period of capital T. One count requires a time period of capital T. Okay. So, to attain a 1 second delay, it will be that TD, that is the 1 second divided by capital T. So, 1 second divided by capital T is the total count, or it is TD into F, 1 by 2 is F. So, that is the initial count of the timer. So initial count of the timer is that much. So ultimately it is 1 second into that much hertz. So it is 15,625 is the timer count, initial count. Yeah. So that should be the count, not the initial count. Sorry. So how many times the timer will count? The timer will count 15,625 times. So the timer should count 15,625 times, okay, to attain a time delay of 1 second. So what should be the initial value? Initial value will be overflow value, overflow number of total states available to attain overflow minus the timer count, minus the timer count. Now the maximum count using 16 bit is what? It is 16 number of ones. 16 number of 1 means FFFFH, double F double F. In decimal equivalent, it is 65,535. So that much of count is the total Tiber count. And plus 1 means 1 count is required to attain overflow. After it attains that much of count, okay, it will take one more count to attain overflow. So total number of count will be 2 to the power 16. 2 to the power 16, that is from 0, it will take 2 to the power 16 number of count, which is equal to 65,536. That is the total number of states required to attain overflow. But it should count only that much value, 15,000 something. So what should be the initial count? Initial count will be, okay, this maximum count possible minus initial count. That must be minus the timer count. That must be the initial count. So if the counter register or the TCNT takes this value from that, it will need from 49,911, it is the value of initial count. From that initial count, it will take 15,625 states or counts to attain overflow. So the value of initial count will be 49,911. Now, what is the hex equivalent? If you convert into the hex, using your calculator or computer, you can easily and directly find out its hex equivalent. Just bring your calculator from decimal mode to hex mode, you can get its hex equivalent. It will be C2F7 hex. That is the initial count of the count register. So our TCNT register must hold that initial count. Get my point? Our TCNT.
Sir, one taki sir overflow at jono nile na. Mane one plus.
After it attains that much of count, it takes one more count to get 00008. So 65,535 means FF, FFX. But that is not the overflow, that is the maximum count. So to attain overflow, one more count is required. So from FFFX, okay, it will go to 00008 after adding one more count to it. So total number of count is 65,536, which is equal to 2 to the power 16. For 16 bit, total number of state is 2 to the power 16. So that is the maximum possible count to attain overflow. Get my point? So that is the maximum possible. And now initial count is calculated this way. So after calculating timer count, we will just subtract the timer count from the maximum possible count for overflow. That will be our initial count. So once we get that particular thing, then what we'll do? We'll load our TCNT value to that particular thing. So it is what? So that will be our TCNT value. TCNT value will be C2X. TCNTH will hold C2X. And TCNTL will hold F7X. Yeah. So after now we start the timer. After we start the timer will start counting. And what we'll do? We'll wait for the timer to attain overflow. And when the overflow is reached, our TOV3 flag will be 1. So we'll create a loop, while loop. If TIFR3 and now 1 less than TOV3 means actually the bit position of the TOV3 is calculated by the type by the compiler. So if you write 1 less than TOV3, it is supported by the compiler. Okay, it means that 1 actually in that particular D0 bit position will come. So it is effectively 0x01 hex. It is effectively 0x01 hex. So that is 1 less than TOV3. Okay. So when TIFR3, its content is ANDed with this particular, it is called actually masking byte. A masking byte is a byte which is used to AND operation. Used to AND with the original byte, original register content. So since there is a 1 which is ANDed with the original content, all other values will be zero except this particular bit position. So if the TOB3 flag is originally 1, the result will be 1. If TOB3 flag is 0, the result will be 0. So we check if the result after ending, if the result is equal to 0, okay, it means our TOB3 flag is not equal to 0. So we will wait for the timer to attain overflow. But once it is equal to 1, then this is not equal to 0, it will be false and it will come out of the while loop. So how long it will stay in the while loop? As long as our TOB3 flag is equal to 0. So it will wait for the TOB, not TOB 0, there is a mistake, it will be TOB 3 actually, it is my mistake, I will change it, okay, so I will change it. So better I do it right now, that will be later I will forget it. So it will be 3, TOB 3 actually, now I save it. Okay, so now that is a, it means that once TOB3 flag is 1, okay, it is the result is not equal to 0 and the while loop will be, and the it will come out of the while loop. So when it is coming out of the while loop, it means that it has attained the overflow. After attaining the overflow, first will stop the counter. Sorry, stop the timer. How to stop? Just make 0, 0, 0. You know, 0, 0, 0 means, just I show you in the CS bits actually, you are using 0, 0, 0. This is to stop the timer. 0, 0. So CS bit should be 0, 0. So you are stopping the timer. Now, so we are stopping the timer. So we are stopping the timer and that is equal to 0, 0, 0. Okay. And the timer will be stopped. Okay. And now our purpose is served. Complete? So now what will be our total program then? Let's see. And after this, what happens? The last step is we will clear the TOB flag. We'll write TIFR3 equal to 0x1 less than TOB3. Or instead of writing that, we could omit 0x also. Simply we could write 1 less than TOB3. So the position of the TOB3 flag will be evaluated by the compiler. The position of the TOB3 flag will be evaluated by the compiler. Then a 1 will come in that position. So when a 1 comes in the TOB3 flag, in the TIFR3 register, it will ultimately clear the TOB3 flag. So when we write a 1, the flag will be cleared. So that is a contradictory thing, it's very peculiar thing, but that is happening actually. Writing a 1 will clear the flag. So that is our step. Now I want to give you the complete program. What is the program? But before that, one more thing, as per our problem, you see, we will design a timer to generate a time delay 1 second. But what will do with the time second? With the delay 1 second, we will just blink one LED. One LED will be connected, okay? One LED will be connected to one pin. The LED will be on for 1 second and will be off for another second. On for 1 second and off for another second. So the LED will be toggled after 1 second. So how to toggle the LED? So I am writing, this is the method of toggling. There are other methods I told you, but now I am giving you another method. Another method of toggling using the XOR operation. Consider that initial bits, some initial bits are stored in a variable V. Say this is the bit, okay? So when we XOR with any chosen byte, any arbitrary byte, so the arbitrary byte is 0x04. Then after XOR operation, what happens? 0 and 1 after XOR, result will be 1. So the result will be 1. And then again, if we XOR it with a 1, then again will be 0. If we XOR it with a 1, then A will be 0. Then 1, 0, 1, 0. After every XOR operation, it will complement. We know XORing with a 1 means complementing the bit. করতে দ্য পার্টিকুলার বিট হিয়ার ফর 0 4 x দ্যাট ডি টু বিট ডি জিরো ডি ওয়ান ডি টু বিট উইল বি টগল্ড কন্টিনিউয়াসলি আফটার এভরি এক্সর অপারেশন সো এক্সর উইথ ওয়ান কমপ্লিমেন্টস আ বিট অ্যান্ড দ্যাট ইজ ইউটিলাইজড হিয়ার ওকে সো উইল রাইট দিস পার্টিকুলার থিং লেটস সি হাউ টু ইউজ ইট ইন আওয়ার প্রোগ্রাম First, we consider we want to connect to an LED with the D4 pin, with the D4 pin of port A. D4 pin of port A. Now, D4 pin of port A means if you see the pin mapping, it will be pin 26 of the Arduino Mega Board. It is the port A.4 is the D4 pin of pin of the microcontroller ATmega2560. In other words, it is the pin 26 of the Arduino Mega2560 board. Yeah, so that is the toggle pin. Now, first we define a function VoIP3 delay function. We will use it repeatedly. Then we just consider the toggle pin as the output pin. Now, write a 1 in the DDRA register. So that pin will be considered as an output pin. Now we can connect LED here. Now, once it is configured as an LED output pin, now we can connect to an LED. Now there is a loop program. First, we introduce a delay of 1 second. T3 delay is a function using timer 3 that will introduce a delay of 1 second. That will introduce a delay of 1 second. So we wait for 1 second, then our port A is toggled. Now 10 hex means what? 10 hex means 0001. So it is something like. So I am showing you. So it is 10. This is 1, then 0000. 10000. So if you toggle it with 10 hex, that D4 bit, D0, D1, D2, D3, D4 bit will be toggled. So one LED is connected here. So when you write 0, port A cap, 0x10, or you can use C++ style of program, then it will be port A cap equal to. If you use C++ style of program, okay. If you write a cap, port A cap equal to 0x10, that also you can write, no problem. See, but I have used your C style, you can use C++ style, no problem. So port A.4 will be toggled after 1 second. So 1 second toggled, 1 second toggled, 1 second toggled, the entire thing will be there indefinitely. So that is our program. Now in this program, only one thing remaining, that is not yet explained. That is the D3. T3 delay. That is that function. So what thing we should write inside T3 delay function to introduce a delay of 1 second? Let's see. I write it in the next line. So via T3 delay function, first we store C2F7H. That is the initial count. That is C2F7H. That is initial count. It should be stored in TCNTH. And TCNTL. So TCNT3H equal to C2H and TCNT3L is equal to F7H. So you are loading the timer count register for timer 3. Then our timer 3 is in normal mode. That is, you see, I already told you that to attend something. Just wait. Yes. So our TCC and 3A must be equal to 0x00 and TCC and 3 equal to 0x05 so that our timer will start with the required prescaler of 1024 and normal mode, the required mode. So TCC and 3 equal to 0x00 and TCC and 3B is 0x05. Okay, there. Now the timer starts counting. The timer starts counting. Then we check whether the overflow flag is 1 or not. Okay, so once the overflow flag is 1, that is it rolls over to 1, then the result will not be equal to 0, result will be 1. So it is false, it will come out of the loop. So when that TOV is equal to 1, it will come out of the loop, while loop. Then we'll stop the timer. We'll stop the timer and again we will clear the timer overflow flag. We'll clear the timer overflow flag. So every time we will call T3 delay function, first the initial count will be loaded, then the timer control register will be accessed. Then we will wait for the timer to roll over to attain overflow. Then we'll stop the timer, then we'll clear the overflow time. That is our method. So that is our program structure then. So our ultimate program is very simple, but there are a lot of understanding required to write a small program. Lot of things are required to know to write a small program. Yeah. So that is our timer. So that is the timer in normal mode. Next. Now we want to see the timer in CTC mode. So in CTC mode, what we do? The timer does not start from initial count. In CTC mode, timer will start from zero value, 0000H. And when it attains some match value, the match value is stored in the OCR register, output compare register. When it attains the match value, its content, that is CMT value, after incrementing from zero is equal to a match value of the OCR content, then the timer will be stopped. Okay, let's see how we can write a program. So here, what happens here? We have to just activate the CTC mode of the timer by configuring proper bit. So our WGM bit will be what? WGM bit will be 0100. That should be the content of the WGM bit in the CTC mode. And we can use our required prescaler value here in the timer. And as usual, our OCA flag is set when an overflow occurs. Overflow, what is the overflow actually? It is not the overflow. I should not write it is actually the overflow. Output compare flag. When a compare, so better I should write a compare match. When a compare match, compare match occurs with timer. Okay, so that is the particular thing we are seeing. Okay, so once a compare match is found, then we have to reset the OCA flag by writing a 1 to it. We have to reset the flag by writing a 1 to this. As usual, this part is same. Only difference is instead of TOB flag, we are clearing OCA flag for this timer 1. For other timer also, you can get it to be OCF 3, OCF 4, OCF 5, all these things. Same procedure is to be applied to other 16-bit timer 3, 4, and 5. Okay. Now, what is the step for writing timer in CTC mode? Choose a timer and the value of prescaler. Timer clock will be slowed down actually. You select the timer mode, it is actually the CTC mode, by using the WGM bits properly. Then we find out what should be the compare match value that will be stored in OCR. And TCNT will always start from zero. That's why our TCNT must be reset always. From zero, it will attain the OCR value. Then step four, if OCR, OCF of TIFR flag is one, counting is complete, will stop the timer. By making all the CS bits equal to zero. In step 5, you will clear the OCA flag by writing a 1 to its position. By writing a 1 to its position. So these are the steps. Let's see. So that is how we want to generate a 1 second delay. What? Using the CDC mode. We use timer 3 chosen. TD 1 second, same thing. But our working principle will be different. We choose a timer and the value of the prescaler. How? Our prescaler, we are choosing a prescaler of say 256. Just we are changing. 256 means 100 for the CS bits. So it is 256. Okay. So it is 256. you are choosing 100. Then for the timer to be attain the CDC mode, what it will be? For CDC mode, we know it should be 0100. So 0100. So our PCCR registers are already configured now with the proper mode and proper prescaler value. So it should be what? PCCR3A is 0100, PCCR3B is 000C. Okay. So that is our now timer in CDC mode. Then we find the value of OCR. Our timer clock. Now we share the screen. So we are back to this particular thing. So now we are choosing the, we have chosen the proper prescaler. So you see this is one. We have chosen the proper prescaler, the 256. Then we have chosen the proper mode, which is the CDC mode. Okay. So this is the CDC mode. Okay. So now what is our TCCR registers? 0x00 and 0x0C. That is 00x and 0CR. These are the two TCCR registers. Then we find the value of OCR. How to do that thing? Our system clock is 16 megahertz oscillator clock by prescaler value 256. You divide it by 256, that will be our 62,250 hertz or 62.25 kilohertz is the timer clock frequency. Timer clock period is 1 by F something. Timer count is what? To attain 1 second, what should be the count? The timer will count, okay, that TD divided by the time required to complete one count. So time to complete one count is capital T. So the required count to complete TD is TD by T. So ultimately it is that much count. So the timer will count from zero value. So the count register TCNT must contain 0000. From that it will attain this particular thing. Note that we are not subtracting the n from 65,536. No, this is not the case. It is a pretty straightforward thing. It is a pretty straightforward thing. Just count value will be loaded into the compare register. Count value will be loaded into the compare register. Yeah. Okay. Now, so once we know this particular thing, so we store it OCR3AX is F3X, OCR3L is 0X2AX, and TCNT3H and 3L, they will contain 00 value. So initial count will be always 0 here. So from initial count, it will attain the compare value that must be stored in the OCR register, the match value. What is our program? And then we'll wait for the flag to roll over. after attaining the match, okay, after attaining the match, when OCF is 1, it will come out of the while loop. When OCF equal to 1, the timer, the compiler will evaluate the position of OCF3A. Compiler will evaluate the position of OCF3A. Okay. And once it's done, then we'll stop the timer by placing zeros in the CS bits. By placing zeros in the CS bits. Stop the timer. Then we will clear the flag by writing a 1. We will clear the flag by writing a 1. So our program is void T3 delay. So that pin is just toggled. Our configured as output pin. Then our port A, that particular pin is toggled. And we are waiting T3 delay. But this T3 delay is defined in a different way. Our OCR register is 0xF32A. So F3 hex and 2A hex. So F3 hex in the higher byte and 2A hex in the lower byte. And TCNT will start from 00 to reach the match value or the compare value. And our TCCR 3A and 3B, these are the timer 3, CTC mode, 1:256, cruise prescaler. Already we know this thing. This TCCR 3A 0x00, TCCR 3B 0x00. So this is the there. Okay, so that is the timer in proper mode. Then we wait for the timer, the flag to set. When it sets, it will come out of the loop. We stop the timer and then we clear the flag. So every time we will call the function, delay function, okay? Every time we call the delay function, that will be always starting, start to load the compare value, then it will reset the counter register, then configure the control register, wait for the timer to attain one value, stop the timer, clear the flag. That is the step. So this is something like, in the Arduino, you know, we have a function, delay function. Delay within bracket 1000 means 1000 millisecond. 1000 millisecond is 1 second. Now our program is effectively T3 delay function. You can write this way or in the previous way. It is equivalently delay within bracket 1000. It is equivalently delay within bracket 1000. So it will waste a time of 1000 second. Millisecond, or it will waste a time of 1 second. So from now on, we can omit the delay function. We can omit the delay function. Moreover, please remember, if I give an assignment to you to write a program where delay function, okay, is required, I always expect that you will write your delay function in your own way. যখনই আমি কোনো অ্যাসাইনমেন্ট দেব যেখানে ডিলে প্রোগ্রামটা কাজে লাগবে, আমি চাইবো যে তোমরা ডিলে প্রোগ্রামটা ওই ডিলে ফাংশনটা ডাইরেক্টলি না লিখে নিজেরা টাইমার দিয়ে ডিলে ফাংশন লিখবে, এটা আমি চাইবো, বুঝেছ? এটা কিন্তু নিজেদেরকে ডিলে যত মিলি সেকেন্ড টাইম লাগবে সেইভাবে ক্যালকুলেট করে এইভাবে ওই কাউন্ট ভ্যালু বসিয়ে টসিয়ে সেইভাবে ডিলে প্রোগ্রাম লিখতে হবে। So a lot modes are actually available. Check me it. আমার একটা ভিডিও ছিল, সেটা কোথায় গেল দাঁড়াও তো, দাঁড়া এক মিনিট, একটা ভিডিও ইনসার্ট করেছিলাম না, দাঁড়া এক মিনিট। ও ও ভিডিওটা এখানে দেওয়া হয়নি, পরে দেওয়া হয়েছে। সো ইট ডাজেন্ট ম্যাটার। ওকে, উইল সি দা ভিডিও লেটার। নাও উই ওয়ান্ট টু সি দা টাইমার ইন, সো দিস দা টাইমার ইন সিটিসি মোড। সো টগলিং অ্যাকচুয়ালি ইজ নট nothing special in the video. So I think that's what's not good. So a lot modes are available with timers. Now we want to see counter operation. A counter that counts up in event driven mode. A counter that counts up in event driven mode. अच्छा तार आगे तू बोली तो तुमरा कि क्यों क्यों माइक्रोकंट्रोलर प्रोग्राम शुरू करे चो बारी ते सिमुलेटर ही हो और तो बाप प्रैक्टिकली आनी है टानी है क्यों की कोच्चो तो कोच्चो ना
यस सर
कोच्चो बार वेरी गुड की नाम तुम्हार
ताली
क्या খাটাখাটি করে করে যখন মাথা ঘামিয়ে করে দেখবে চলছে খুব ভালো লাগবে খুবই ভালো লাগবে মনে হবে ইট ইজ ইউর ব্রেন চাইল্ড নিজের তৈরি করা জিনিস অন্যের থেকে ধার করা জিনিস নয় ঠিক আছে So that is the timer. Now I want to go to the counter operation. Like timer, counter can work in normal mode and CDC mode. I am in a class. I'll call you later after the class. So like timer, counter can work in normal mode. Okay. Here counter can work in normal mode. Okay. As well as in CDC mode. Now same registers are used exactly in the same way. Only thing is, okay, the instead of AVRs, crystal clock or the system clock or oscillator clock, an external pulse train must be applied. Okay, to some particular pin of the counter. So that pin will act as the source of triggering for counting. So what are those external pins? For timer 0, T0 pin is there in the microcontroller, in the Arduino board. For timer 1, T1 pin. For timer 2, T2 pin. Timer 3, T3. Timer 4, T4. Timer 5, T5 pins. Okay. Are used to receive external pulse for such triggering. But in the Arduino board, the T3 pin and T4 pins of the Atmega microcontroller, 2560 microcontroller, are not brought out to the Arduino Mega 2560 board terminal. ঠিক আছে এটা খেয়াল রাখবে তুমি কিন্তু যদি কাউন্টার মোডে কাজ করতে চাও তোমার তো T3 বা T4 পিনে এক্সটার্নাল পালসটা অ্যাপ্লাই করতে হবে সেই পালসটা দেবে কিন্তু পাঁচটা যে দেবে আরডুইনো মেগা বোর্ডে কিন্তু ওরা ওই 8 মেগা মাইক্রোকন্ট্রোলার থেকে T3 আর T4 পিনটা বাইরে টেনে আনেনি কিন্তু T3 আর T4 পিনস আর নট অ্যাভেলেবল এই কানেকশনটা ওরা করেনি কারণ একটা মাইক্রোকন্ট্রোলারে তো অনেক পিন থাকে সব পিন ওরা ওই বোর্ডে ফিট করাতে পারেনি ওই জন্য ওরা এই কানেকশনটা করেনি তার মানে কি ইউ ক্যান নট অ্যাপ্লাই এনি এক্সটার্নাল পালস ওকে ইন দ্য counter 3 or counter 4. Timer 3 in the counter mode means counter 3 and timer 4 in the counter mode means counter 4. So you cannot use timer 3 and timer 4 or counter 3 or counter 4 in the counter mode if you use Arduino Mega 2560 board. তোমরা যদি নিজেরা মাইক্রোকন্ট্রোলার কিনে কানেকশন করে টোরে চালু করে দিতে পারো তাহলে সেখানে তুমি T3 T4 পিনটা পেয়ে যাবে কিন্তু আরডুইনো মেগা 2560 বোর্ডে এই দুটো পিন নেই তাহলে তোমাদের কোন পিনে করতে হবে কাউন্টার অপারেশনের জন্য T1 বা T5 পিন T1 অর T5 পিন দিস টু পিনস আর অ্যাভেলেবল ঠিক আছে সো নাও হিয়ার এক্সটার্নাল পালস মাস্ট বি অ্যাপ্লাইড হিয়ার দিস ইজ আওয়ার TX পিন X মিন্স 0 X means 1, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 0 আর 2টা বাদ দিচ্ছি কারণ ওটা 8 বিট টাইমার আমরা 1, 3, 4, 5 নিয়ে মাথা ঘামাবো ঠিক আছে? সো ইন আওয়ার কেস ইট উইল বি t1 অর t t1 অর t5, ওকে? দ্যাট ইজ দিস নাও কাউন্টার ইন নরমাল মোড. Now again, this is your register. So counter in normal mode. Our normal mode will be as usual. Okay. So this will be then first quarter 0-0. But here the difference is in the CSB. It will act as the CSB should be configured properly so that the external pulse will be received at the TX pin or TN pin. T0, T1, T2, T3, any external pulse. And the timer will count either on the falling edge or the rising edge. That depends on this bit content. তার মানে তুমি যে external pulse টা apply করেছো, timer টা edge detection করবে rising edge বা falling edge. এবং তারপর সেটা pass করবে counter mode এবং তখন timer টা count করবে বা counter টা count করবে ওই rising edge বা falling edge. তাহলে rising edge বা falling edge is dictated by the CS bits in any one of the two mode or two possible combination. Any one of the two possible combination. And as usual, TOB one is set when overflow occurs, and TOB one is also cleared by writing a logic one as usual. Other timers are also available, but for Arduino application, you cannot use T3 and timer 3 and timer 4. Okay, it will be timer 1 and timer 5. Okay. Now let's see our program. But the thing is, how to generate an external pulse? How to generate an external pulse? First, we will create a pulse, okay, by using a separate Arduino Mega board. It is board 1. The purpose of using board 1 is to generate pulse train. And we are generating a pulse train in the pin number 43 of the Arduino Mega board. And that pulse is applied to another Arduino Mega board, board 2. Okay, and where it is applied? It is applied to the T5 pin of the Arduino Mega board. And we want that the counter 5 will count up on every falling edge of the pulse available at the T5 pin. And once it counts up, the count value will be stored in the port A. So that the port A will dictate the number of pulse, the port A will contain the number of pulse counted. The port A will, okay, contain the number of pulse counted. So how you can do it? See, this is our board, our Arduino Mega 2560 board. Here pin number 43, pin number 43 means it is the D6 bit, D6 pin of ports L, D6 pin of port L. If you see the pin mapping, you will get. We will write a program or sketch here to generate a pulse train, and now that pulse will be externally connected to the pin 47 of the second board. Now pin 47 means it is the, why pin 47, why not anything? Because as per the specification, pin 47 is the T5 pin. Pin 47 is the T5 pin through which the second board, a second mega board, will receive the externally applied pulse for its counter related operation. It will receive the externally applied pulse for its counter related operation, counter operation. And the every count value that it counts will be thrown to the port A pin. We can connect some LEDs or something else. So the count value will be stored here. Port A means pin number 2029. So that is this particular thing. So in Arduino board 1, mega board 1, PL6 is the digital pin 43. So we will generate a pulse here. And that through some jumper wire, pin number 43 will be connected to pin number 47. So that the pulse generated by board 1 will reach pin number 47 or T5 pin of second board, and then on every rising edge of the pulse, or sorry, on every falling edge of the pulse, the second board will count up. The counter of the second board will count up the value, and the corresponding value will be thrown to the port A. That is pin number 22, 29, 14. So that is our operation. Get my point? Any doubt? If you have any doubt, ask me. কোনো ডাউট থাকলে কিন্তু জিজ্ঞেস করবে, আমি আমার কোনো তাড়া নেই, আমি ধীরে ধীরে যাব। ওকে, লেটস সি। তার মানে আমাকে দুখানা প্রোগ্রাম লিখতে হবে, টু রাইট টু প্রোগ্রামস, ওয়ান ফর জেনারেটিং পালস ইন বোর্ড ওয়ান, অ্যানাদার ফর রাইটিং কাউন্টার প্রোগ্রাম ইন বোর্ড টু। নাও উই আর কানেক্টিং সাম এলইডিস ইন দ্য বোর্ড টু। You can connect 7 segment LEDs or anything else also, no problem. Let's see our program. Pin number 6, the 6 pin of port L. The 6 pin of port L means pin number 43 of mega 2560 is used to generate pulse 10. Now port L, the 6 pin is configured as output port. D6 pin is configured as output port. We throw a 1 here. So this is the program or sketch for board 1. Now here we are writing a simple delay program. Kintu ami chaibo tumra nijera jokhon likhbe, we have to generate some 250 millisecond here. Tar mane 250 millisecond wait korchi, tale tar pore ei pulse ta high hocche. Abar 250 millisecond pulse low. High, low, high, low. So what is the duration? 1 high plus 1 low will be 250 plus 250. So it will be 500 millisecond. One high plus one low will be 500 millisecond. So that is that time period of the pulse, 500 millisecond. Now our timer, our counter will be in the normal mode, and the CS bits will be 110. The counter will act as a counter mode, and it will count by receiving a pin externally applied pulse. Okay, and it will count up on falling edge. So now we want to write a program in board 2. Our board 1 program is already there, sketch for board 1. So this is the sketch for board 1 already written. Now sketch for board 2. So it is that counter mode. 110 we are choosing. So 110 we are choosing. So the content of TCCR A is 0800 and TCCR B is 0806. And the counter starts counting from 0, hence the initial count will be reset, will be 0. 0000, hence initial count will be 0. So these are the TCMT registers. And TCCR already there. Then we clear TOV5 flag. Counter operation TOV5 normal mode. So you write a logic 1. So if it is not equal to 1, if it is equal to 1, it will stay in the, it will just reset. And if it is not 1, it will not reset. That is another way of doing things. And we need not stop the counter, because if there is no external edge, okay, external pulse, the counter will not count up. our program T5 pin. T5 pin is what? It is the pin number 47 of portal. It is pin number 47 means is the D2 pin of portal. It is the D2 pin of portal. D2 pin of portal. PL2. So D2 pin of portal. Then portal is output. Then portal is configured as portal output and portal. One particular pin, that is the PL.2, will be configured as an input pin. Why input pin? We are resetting, making it zero. We are sending a zero to that pin in the DDI register for portal. So that pin will now accept, will be configured as an input pin. Now it will accept the counter pulse. So now it will accept. So it will accept the pulse. So that pin will be configured as an input pin. It will act as an input pin. So it's configured. Next, we set the count to zero. We shall count zero. Then this is your 5-bit, timer 5, normal mode in counter operation. This is your 5B006. T5 mode, counter in counter mode, and the following edge is also now there, accepted. Then what happens? We throw the count value, just the lower byte is thrown actually, upper byte will not come. First, the port we are placing the lower byte of counter register. Then we clear the TV flag. If it is not 1, if it is 1, we will clear it. We will clear the TV flag. Okay, so counter is counting up. Counter, whenever we connect some external pulse, there are 2 megabord not shown here. 1 megabord is generating the pulse, and the second megabord is just incrementing. Complete. But counter in CDC mode will not be discussed in our class. That is not required. Only one mode is sufficient for our purpose. Only one mode is, so I will skip this. I will not circulate it to you. It is not required. So that is the end of chapter 5. I will send you the tutorial for that presentation today right now. Any question before that? No question.
Sir. Hello.
হ্যাঁ বলো শুনছি
স্যার বোর্ড 1 আর বোর্ড 2 মানে দুটো 1 মেগা বোর্ড না একটা বোর্ড থেকে পিন পিন পোর্টালের পিন 6 থেকে জেনারেট করে সিগন্যাল পোর্টালের পিন দিয়ে পাঠালে হবে নাকি দুটো আলাদা বোর্ড
তো সম্পূর্ণ আলাদা বোর্ড একটা বোর্ড থেকে করব না করিনি দুই একই বোর্ড থেকে করলে অসুবিধা হতে পারে একটা বোর্ডের কাজ হচ্ছে এক্সটার্নাল পালস সাপ্লাই করা আসলে এটা একটা প্র্যাকটিক্যাল পালস হতে পারে ইট উইল বি ইভেন্ট ড্রিভেন দ্যাট পালস ইট মে কাউন্ট দ্য নাম্বার অফ প্রোডাক্ট পাসিং থ্রু আ কনভেয়ার বেল্ট কনভেয়ার বেল্টে পরপর পরপর ধরো বিস্কিট যাচ্ছে একটা করে বিস্কিটের প্যাকেট যাবে একটা করে পালস আসবে আবার একটা করে বিস্কিট যাবে প্যাকেট একটা করে পালস আসবে তাহলে কতগুলো বিস্কুটের প্যাকেট আমরা গুনবো কি করে কতগুলো পালস এলো তার পালস কাউন্ট করতেই হবে এবার এক্সটার্নাল পালস টাইম পাবো কি করে বা একটা করে গাড়ি যাচ্ছে রাস্তা দিয়ে একটা করে পালস যাচ্ছে তাহলে সেই পালস গুলো গোনা মানে গাড়িটাকে গোনা কতগুলো গাড়ি যাচ্ছে তাহলে একটা তাই পালস গুলোকে আমরা জেনারেট করতে হবে তো আমাদের প্রোগ্রামটা টেস্ট করার জন্য তাহলে হাউ টু জেনারেট তার এই জন্য আমরা আরেকটা মেগাবোর্ড নিয়েছি তোমরা মেগাই নিতে হবে তার কোনো ব্যাপার নেই তোমরা এই কাজটা একদম সেম প্রোগ্রাম তোমরা যদি উনোতেও লেখো ইউ রাইট দা দিস প্রোগ্রাম ইন দা উনো সরি কোথায় গেল ইয়েস সিলভার, শুধু পিনের ম্যাপিংটা আলাদা হয়ে যাবে গুলোতে। অর্থাৎ পিনের যে পিনের নাম্বারটা আমি বললাম 43 পিন হচ্ছে এটা, হয়তো নাম্বারটা পাল্টে যাবে, দেখে নিতে হবে, কিন্তু ব্যাপারটা কোনো ফারাক নেই। এবার পালসটা যে জেনারেট হয়ে গেল একটা বোর্ড দিয়ে, এবার যে বোর্ডটা আসল বোর্ড আমরা এতদিন কাজ করেছি সেইটাতে আমরা মেগা বোর্ড হতে হবে ওটা, সেখানে পিন নাম্বার 47 যেটা T5 পিন, ওখান দিয়ে আমরা ওই পালসটাকে রিসিভ করব। ও কাউন্ট করবে যে কতগুলো পালস রিসিভ করলো, এই প্রোগ্রাম দিয়ে ও পালস কাউন্ট করবে। ঠিক আছে
স্যার, ওই পালসটা যদি স্যার অন্য কোনো ভাবে জেনারেট করলেও হবে, যেমন স্যার ওই
কেন হবে
ট্রিপল
না,
ফাইভ
আমি তো
আইসি
সেটাই
ট্রিপল
বললাম, একদম ভেরি গুড, তুমি 555 IC দিয়ে করো না, খুব ভালো। ওটা 0 to 5 volt স্কেলে রাখতে হবে, এটা খেয়াল রাখবে। আইসির আউটপুট পিনটাকে ওই কন্ট্রোল পিনটাকে ওটাকে 5 ভোল্টের আনতে হবে, একটা তো বায়াসিং সাপ্লাই হয়, আর একটা হচ্ছে আউটপুটের স্ট্যাটাসের জন্য একটা পিন আছে, ওটাকে 5 ভোল্টে টাই আপ করতে হবে। ওটা যেন 12 ভোল্ট না হয়, তাহলে ওভার ভোল্টেজ হয়ে যাবে, 12 ভোল্ট 15 ভোল্ট না হয়, তাহলে তুমি ওই IEEE 555 টাইমার দিয়ে তুমি হার্ডলি হাইলি করতে পারো, কোনো অসুবিধা নেই, নো প্রবলেম। তুমি ফাংশন জেনারেটর দিয়ে করতে পারো, মোট কথা তোমার একটা পালস চাই। এখন আমি বাড়ি বসে করছি, আমি তো আর ল্যাবে নেই, ল্যাবে থাকলে হাজার রকম মেথড থাকে, আমি বাড়ি বসে পালস জেনারেট করছি, তা কি করে করব? তো সেই জন্য আমি এটা তোমার ওই এইভাবে জেনারেট করেছি। আমার কাছে প্রচুর মেগা বোর্ড আছে, ধরো আমি জানি না গোটা 15 মেগা বোর্ড আছে আমার কাছে, আমি একটা বোর্ড আরেকটা নিয়ে নিয়েছি। আমার একটা ওয়ার্কশপ করার ভবিষ্যতে ইচ্ছে আছে, ওই একদিন দুদিনের ওয়ার্কশপ করলে হবে না, যেটা আমি ইন্ডাস্ট্রিতে করে থাকি, ইন্ডাস্ট্রিতে অনেক দিনের ওয়ার্কশপ করি, অনেক দিনে, এমনকি 1 মাসেরও ওয়ার্কশপ করেছি এরকম এমবেডেড সিস্টেমস এর উপর। 1 মাস দরকার নেই, অন্তত তোমার 4-5 দিনেরও যদি হয়, 7 দিনের যদি একটা ওয়ার্কশপ হয়, এটা করা যায় নিজেদের উদ্যোগ নিয়ে। এখন তো আর হবে না এই কোভিডের বাজারে, কারণ সামনাসামনি করার দরকার, কারণ হাজার জনের আমি হাজার রকম প্রবলেম হবে, স্যার আমার প্রোগ্রাম রান করছে না, একটা এরর দিয়েছে, আমি এখন কি করে বুঝবো কি এরর? এবার আমাকে সামনাসামনি থাকতে হবে, তবে তো আমি বুঝবো যে তুমি এইখানে এই ভুলটা করেছো, ফলে এগুলো অনলাইনে হয় না। যাই হোক, ঠিক আছে, ক্লিয়ার, এনি ডাউট? তাহলে আমি তোমাদের মেটেরিয়ালটা এখনই পাঠিয়ে দেবো, শুধু এইটা কাউন্টার ইন সিডিসি মোডটা থাকবে। সো নাও দেন আই ওয়ান্ট টু স্টপ, ওকে, আওয়ার চ্যাপ্টার ইজ কমপ্লিট, চ্যাপ্টার অন টাইমার। থ্যাংক ইউ, আই ক্লোজ ইট নাও।